This is like all the beach movies where they're fighting over some girl and biking, of course, motorcycles, yes. It reminds me of this Disney movie I've watched. So earlier today, a new music video came out and I'm super duper excited to be reacting to it. And that music video is Lip Gloss by The BOYZ. As you guys know, I absolutely love The BOYZ and I just have to react to them every single time they release a new music video. So I'm really, really excited about this one. And Jihyun actually mentioned that there is a plot twist somewhere in this music video. So I have to look for that. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to find it, but I really want to look for it. So yeah, let's get started. See. Ooh. They're out traveling or something? Oh, it looks so nice. Wow. They're out in the ocean. Oh, I love this mixture of filming like both underneath water and then over water. That's so cool. Oh, they saw a girl. I love the film grain they have added. It gives that old kind of film look. It's so nice. This is like a movie. Oh, it looks like an old beach movie. Oh, this is so cozy. Oh, look at that shallow depth of field. Wow. I'm loving these close-ups of the members. It looks so good. I'm a big fan of playing around with where you put the focus in the frame. And I love how they put it in the middle. So you get like this really like shallow kind of depth of field. Wow. Oh my god. What was that? What was that? Are they all like trying to like get her attention and they're like flirting with her? Wow. In romance movies, for example, you use shallow depth of field to represent that someone is very interested in someone because in that moment you only focus on that person. That's the only thing you see, so everything else feels like a blur in a sense. So it works really well with kind of like isolating the person from the rest of the environment because all of your focus is on that person, and it just goes really well with this romantic vibe they're going for here. Oh wow, she's catching everyone's attention. Oh, they're all fighting over the same girl. This is like all the beach movies where they're fighting over some girl and biking, of course, motorcycles, yes. It reminds me of this Disney movie I've watched. Oh my god. It's so cute though. The lighting on Jihyun here, whoa, that's so beautiful. With all of the green in the background, it's just super soft. Like the soft focus is just so good. Wow. Wow. I love the lighting here on the motorcycle scene as well. It's just so beautiful. It's very warm and soft and high-key, but at the same time low-key enough, so it doesn't really, you know, pop too much. It's just absolutely perfect. There is something about the quality of the lighting here. That's just so cool. Whoa, look at this shot. With the shoes here, and then you can see Sunwoo coming out from the back, and then they change the focus from the shoes to him. And everything is like in the rule of third as well, so it just looks very appealing. It just looks very nice. So Black Mist is pretty much a filter that you put in front of the camera lens to give this kind of glowy look to the lightings in the rooms. Oh my god, they made all of these like really cute dates. They're all like super cute dates. This is adorable. Look here, how they're playing like with the foreground being... Oh, this is so nice as well. What a beautiful composition. Like, you see that here, like the greens at the end, they form like a circle and they're out of focus, and then you have like them in the middle in focus. It's so nice. It's just so nice. This one here, Hanyu. Wow. With like the bouquet behind him, you get that light here from the far side on his face. And the way she's out of focus, and you have like this beautiful reflection in this like kind of table kind of thing here, just looks very nice. And with this like white shirt as well, is really pretty. Oh, that's beautiful. Wow, I really like this one. I have so much to say about the cinematography. I'm just trying to take in everything that's happening right now. Look here, wow, once again, just like these shots here of Hanyun, you see with the lighting and the colors and everything, it just looks so freaking good. Oh, it looks beautiful. Hanyun did you well, like this is beautiful. I love how, you know, you get like this lens flare here and then it stops right when his eyes get into focus. That's when she's realizing that, oh my gosh, it's him. Wow. Oh, well, they're at the beach playing. Youngun is out with the girl again. Oh, guys, if you only knew. The song is so refreshing. Wow. Oh, they look so cute. Gosh, I love this composition as well. Absolutely, just everything with like this, you know, party here at the end with all the colors is just so nice. It's just really pretty. It gives that kind of summer look, but at the same time, the colorfulness of Christmas, you know, with Christmas lights being in like blue, red, yellow, green, it gives that kind of feeling. But at the same time, it has like this tropical summer feeling. So I do get why they combined like Christmas with August, because it looks really, really nice. She's going to someone else. Oh. Did they like choose surfing over a girl, but then someone else is hitting on them? And then they're having a dance party. This is like a beach movie. Wow. Oh my gosh. I'm loving this one take. I don't see one take that often in music videos anymore. I feel like, you know, with our generation, we want things to be like edited very fast, but there's just something so refreshing about a one take. It's so nice. You know, so a lot of people are probably watching this music video and thinking, why did they end the video with like 2 minutes of like a full one take? Like it might remind you a little bit of a performance video that idols sometimes upload. And as I mentioned, I actually really liked it that they used one take. I think it's cool that they dare to do something else. And as I mentioned, with like short format kind of videos being big these days, reels, TikToks, and just short videos, I feel like people are losing their attention spans. People can't watch anything longer than like 15 to 30 seconds. And people need like quick editing all the time. It is something that I actually learned from going to film school and learning about film history, that when you look back at like old movies and how things were made back in the days, you would actually use a lot longer shots, mainly because it was kind of expensive to film a lot of angles. It took a lot of time. So it was easier to get it in one take, you know, but you just had to get that one take right. But the members here, they're so professional. They practiced this choreo so many times that so for them, there's no issue in doing a one take. And for the camera crew as well, as long as they get to practice a couple of times with the group and keep a very high depth of field so they can catch as much focus as they want in the video, they're able to actually film a one take pretty well. It's just composition that might be a little bit hard, and once again, focus can be a bit hard, but at the same time, you know, it saves them from doing a lot of different angles. And at the same time, I think it's kind of nice. You have the beginning of the music video where it's all about each of them, each of the individual members going for this girl. It's like they're competing against each other. But now here at the end of the music video, they're united as a friend group. They're telling themselves that, yeah, we shouldn't be fighting over a girl. We should just, you know, have fun and hang out with each other because we're friends. And that's why the entire end is a dance performance, because there is no summer movie and beach movie, which is a musical, without having a little performance at the end. So I feel like this is like the ending performance of the movie, and it's them being united and doing everything together. So it makes sense that it's a one long one take of them just being together. It's a really cool way of showing the contrast between how they were around each other when they were fighting over this one girl, and how they are now when they're realizing that none of them are getting the girl. Also, this choreo is so cute. Wow. Oh, they have like Christmas elements on their clothing. I can see that now. Wow, but I'm really liking this. Wow, I just love how they managed to make a one take look so creative and fun. You know, they could have just kept the camera like in one place, but they're going back and forth with the camera, zooming in and out, playing around with the lighting. It just adds something extra to the one take. That's so cute. And that was the end. Oh, wow. I just have so much to like say. I realize that now, but I have so much to talk about. But oh my gosh, I really like this one. It was so cute. That was such a fun music video, and it just really gave me this nice summer vibe, even though summer is pretty much over by now, and right now we have a storm coming to my country, so it's just raining here right now, but it still gave me that, you know, fresh, nice summer vibe that I've been missing. So nice. Yeah, so nice. Such a good way to start the week. Also, today, as I'm filming this, it's actually Youngun's birthday. So happy birthday to Youngun. I hope he's having a really good birthday today. He deserves it. He's 26 today, I think. Wow, that's cool. I really enjoyed this video. The boys are releasing a series of music videos this year, so this was the first one, and they're gonna release two more, and I just can't wait to watch them. This music video was so refreshing, and I really liked it. I loved, once again, I love the cinematography, just everything from the grading to the softness of it, the shallow depth of field, the lighting, everything, just the pro mist filter. It's just so inspiring. Like, I want to create cinematography like this. This is what I want to do. I just have to get a little bit better first, but I'm trying. So yeah, wow, that was really good. I just love being able to, you know, analyze their work as well, because they're so talented and they're so good. And I've been keeping up with every single music video by them since I started listening to them like 5 years ago when they released Right Here. And ever since then, I've just been, you know, looking through their music videos, analyzing everything. And it just feels so nice to be able to, you know, share it somewhere on a platform, you know, with all of you guys. It's amazing. I'm very happy. And the members, they're just so good, and I just can't wait to hear the rest of the album. I know a lot of the members have been working on the album as well with the writing, and I'm super excited to just hear every single song, and I'm so proud of them, you know. They're really working hard, and they just deserve all of the respect for their hard work and everything they put into their work. And yeah, I really, you know, I really look up to them for that. These days I have a lot going on myself, and I'm so thankful for them because they have inspired me so much to just keep on going for my own dreams and grow as a creative. And yeah, they're just so good. They're just so amazing. Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh, this is fun. Oh, yeah. I always listen to, you know, I always listen to albums from like beginning to the end, from like the first to the last song, because actually Kevin mentioned this once. And I learned that from him, but the order of songs on an album is usually very well planned out, because it's like a story from the beginning to the end, and sometimes the songs just flow very well into each other. So every time I listen to a full album of an artist that I like for the first time, I always start at the first song and end with the last song. So I'm gonna do that with this one. I just had to check out Passion Fruit, because I heard my boy Kevin worked on this one, that he helped writing on this one. Gosh, he's really good at writing. He is. You know, because he's released some solo projects. I really like the songs he has released on SoundCloud. They're really good. So yeah, I even used them in a video earlier this year. So yeah, I gotta listen to it for my boy, you know. He did a good job. I can already hear it. I'm just like loving the beat of this song and the lyrics that I've seen so far. So I can't wait to hear all of the song. I bet it's so good, but I'm gonna be listening to that on my own. We don't have time to watch me listen to the entire album. But my boy Kevin, you're one really talented man, and you just deserve the respect in the world and all of the credits for all of your work, because I'm so proud of you, and you work really hard, and you only deserve the best. So I will remember that and keep that in mind and keep that in my heart as I'm listening to this album for the first time. Yeah. Okay, but now I gotta stop. It's getting late and I should sleep. So yeah, that was everything for today. I hope you guys enjoyed my video, and I will be back soon with another one. Bye!